In the last video, I installed my stepper motors and programmed the variable frequency drive which will power my water-cooled spindle. In this video, I will connect all the tubing for the spindle's cooling system and install the drag chains. I am planning on using a G 1/4 inch compression fitting, which I bought as a pack of 6 from a computer accessory supplier. That fitting happens to be the same thread as a 1/4 inch BSP, and will secure the PVC cooling pipes to the spindle, its pump, and the cooling radiator. The spindle end has an M8 thread with a 1-inch pitch, so I'm going to have to use an adapter. I found some adapters that happened to fit from an engineering supplies company, which were for an industrial lubrication system. I've also decided to go with larger tubing, because the fittings feel a little more secure than the barb variety. I added these to the spindle end and then the compression fittings, which will take a tube with a 10mm inner diameter and a 13mm outer diameter. I made sure not to over tighten the nail knobs on the compression fittings when installing the tube. I want to run the cooling tubes through the drag chain just to keep everything neat and prevent any accidents happening. But before that, I will connect the cooling system all together. I'm using a large 200mm computer case radiator with a 180mm fan. To fit the fan onto the radiator, I had to re-tap the mounting holes on the plate to the size of the machine screws I had available. The pump and fan will be powered by a 12V PSU, which I will eventually install into a new controller. Liquid will go from the spindle to the radiator, cooled, and then to the pump. After connecting the cooling tubes together, I ran them through the drag chains to feel how flexible they would be, and begin imagining the appropriate way to install. But in doing this, I also realised my spindle cable, which has 4 1.5mm flexes, was just too thick, and would limit movement. The spindle I'm using is rated to draw 5 amps, so I can change this to a cable with 1mm cores, keeping the drag chain flexible. While I wait for the EMI braiding and new cable to arrive in the post, I'm going to make the brackets for the drag chain using a length of 40x40mm aluminium angle bar. As I'm not working from a 3D model of my machine, I will have to tailor these parts to the machine itself by measuring, cutting, drilling, and hoping that they fit. I use my vernier caliper as a marking gauge, beginning from the spindle end, working back to the cable entrance. I had to dismantle some parts of the machine to fit the brackets, but the process wasn't too difficult. I mean, it would have been nice to make these using a 3D printer, but I don't have one. I have a table saw instead. I want to fit as many of the brackets on pre-existing fixings, saving myself from having to make changes to the plates. Here the 90 degree angle brackets I place under the X-axis aluminium extrusion find an additional use. I have to double up this section to hold the two ends of the X and Y drag chain, securing with locking nuts and M5 dome machine screws. I'm going to use the water cooling fan to draw air through the new control box that I'm planning to build. This radiator, which I bought second hand, can also fit two sets of tubings, allowing me to fantasize about having a CNC farm. I'm using a drag chain which can be unclipped and open to make installing the wiring and tubing a hell of a lot easier. I secured the last bracket and the machine is essentially ready to use, minus the proximity sensors and a quick install of the replacement power spindle cable. In the future, I will make a fully loaded and future-proof control box based upon the Phoenix CNC controller, which will run the variable frequency drive, individual stepper drivers, and utilize a bit leveling probe. I will be releasing a written accompaniment of this project once I have won the lottery and don't have to go to work. Thanks again to everyone who has followed and supported the build, and as usual, don't forget to sacrifice a thumb and let me know your comments and questions.